I started off, you know, you fumble around on your instrument just for a bit of fun, and then you discover that more serious stuff later on. You know, which way did it go for you? Did you start, you know, noodling around with music, not really realizing this importance, and then discovered it later on? Or was there always a kind of like, you know, this thing about music and it's important and this is serving that rather than the other way around? Did that come from an early age, or?
It's hard to say. I mean, it all just kind of
happened.
Blended together. Yeah, it's like, heard Kiss, I want to be a rock star. Heard the Beatles, I love music.
Right.
And the two sort of...
And the guitar playing wasn't happening at this point in time?
At that point, I wanted to be a bass player, but I was too young. I went to a store, I was like, I want to be a bass player. I want to be Gene Simmons. And like, well, you know, they told me, well, start on acoustic guitar, and then after 2 years, then maybe switch to bass.
Right.
And I just stayed with guitar, and I can play bass now, but...
Right, and you just liked it.
But yeah, so I stuck with it, and during that time, I think I was more of an Angus Young type player.
Right.
If I had to compare to anything.
Okay.
I was definitely, I think Angus was a big inspiration as far as, you know, be at band practice and just be running around the room stomping and just... Mm. Being all crazy and stuff. And then someone said to me when I was about 12, have you heard of this guy named Eddie Van Halen? I was like, Eddie who, what? And put on the intro to Mean Street. And I had never heard anything like that before in my life.
And you hadn't
like,
even heard the previous Van Halen albums at that point?
No, that was the first thing I heard. Wow. Was that. And then he's like, I'll make you a tape, check it out. And gave me Eruption. And I remember I was so just amazed by it all and just so curious and so inspired and just so, you know, I need to decode this and figure out what's going on here. It's a totally different thing that I didn't know could be done with a guitar. I just didn't think about it. And I remember I took the tape of Eruption and I learned it by ear. I got it down and then I took apart the cassette, flipped the reels, and then learned it backwards.
No way.
Yeah.
Can you still remember how to do any of that?
It might take a good minute. It might take a good minute or a thousand, but it was just like, you know. And then it was like, you know, just going in and going up. And going through the whole thing, but I had it all down from end to beginning backwards.
What was your reason for that?
I just wanted to know it forwards and backwards.
You just wanted to know, like people say, oh, you know, I know it back to front.
Yeah.
And you literally wanted to do that.
Yeah. And I just got really into, at that point, the guitar and what else can you do with this thing? What else can you do with the strings? What else can you do on the strings? That's the whole thing. Before that, it was just about, I mean, it was still about, you know, I was writing classic rock sounding songs at age 10 about, you know, whatever girl I liked in school. And I didn't really think about, what's the word? Getting inventive or creative or...
Moving forward, progressing in any kind of harmonic way or whatever, you were just happy.
I didn't think that that was even an option. I didn't know that that road existed. And I started getting into UK and Holdsworth and Blue and that and Fripp and that whole crowd of dudes. And from there, then I heard Yngwie for the first time. Right. I was like, whoa, now what is that now? What's he doing there? And, you know, I heard, you know, with Keel Steeler.
Right.
And so I had to learn his, you know, solo that he had on the album, you know? And go through the whole thing of that and yeah, just started getting in. Then, you know, this guy named Steve Vai plays with Zappa. And getting into all of that and just like everybody, you know, you hear all these amazing guitar players that are rising up with their unique styles that they had, and you got to explore it. And each one adds a little something to you and just makes you enjoy it that much more. It's refreshing.
Yeah.
So I just got into it and I was doing my own thing. I was like, all right, you got this neck, you got the string, and the notes keep going, but the neck stops. How can I get to these? So I used to have a 9-volt battery on a rubber band and a string that I would grab and use as a slide to get the higher notes.
Right.
And eventually I found out it was just too cumbersome. So I started, I was about 18 at that point, and I was building my own guitars, modifying them, coming up with all these horrible monstrosities. I should never be allowed near a guitar and any kind of power tool at the same time because it goes bad.
Are you going to start making some garments? Because, oh, right, I get
it. Well, this button's getting loose,
Yeah.
So I started using this thing where I would use it to kind of like a slide to get the rest of the notes out that I needed. So I would use it, let's say you're tapping something and you need, you can get the extra note there.
Yeah.
So that's how I just throw in an extra note using that. If you're on this pickup,
right,
you're gonna be picking up everything in front of the pickup, so you can get all the higher notes to it, whatever it is, you know? And you get those things out. Yeah. If you're on this pickup, what happens is you can get up to that point and then the note disappears, but what you can do is if you hold it down here, it's almost like the string is not going to be vibrating from the nut to the bridge, it'll be vibrating from the nut to this. Where if you hold it down, so it's almost like taking your bridge and sliding it forward, thus making the string shorter, thus making the neck longer in comparison and raising the pitch of your notes. So if you have, and you put this down, and you can get more notes there.
Mm.
So you can do a lot of things where you're